Okay, today we'll be showing you how to use a bench vise and a dog leash to make a spring compressor for your air gun. So let's get started.
The first thing we'll do is establish the center line of the screw of the bench vise. I'm using a 4-inch bench vise. If you've got one mounted on a table already, that's fine. I'm using a 2x6 by 48 inches for this, to show you guys how it's done. So we establish the center line of this screw. Don't have to be all that accurate, and then we center line at approximately 5 inches away from the jaw. We're catering to have at least 4 inches of preload on the spring on the air gun. So we go right down the line and establish that. Next we'll need a couple of pieces of 2x3s. You can use any scrap. If you go to Home Depot in the lumber section where they cut the lumber, you can probably get some pieces for free. You just have to ask the guys if there are any offcuts. So I'm actually using a piece of 2x3 and a piece of 2x2. Okay, so I am the gun I'll be working on, the action is about 32 inches long. So I'm locating the first 2x3 5 inches away. That's all 5 inches, and I'm just going to tack this down. Two of them in using some 1.5 inch finishing nails. So that's done. Next I'm going to locate the other piece. A little further down. So I've already established the center line corresponding the center line there. And I've done the same on the other one. So we'll just go ahead and tack this down. So the next thing we'll do is we've put about 1 inch away from both of the pieces of wood. We'll put in 2 staples, 1-inch staples. I've already done those. And then next, 6 4-inch nails, approximately midway between the 2 pieces of wood, and approximately 1.5 to 2 inches spaced between them. Next, we'll put 2 3-inch finishing nails to the side of the center line, and the approximate width of the action that you'll be working on. So the action is going to fit in between there. I put some tape around them to prevent scratching of the action. Now on the other, we're just going to use 4 1-inch finishing nails. And the reason for that is similar to this, and that would be to stabilize and to keep the muzzle of the gun for the action centered. So we'll wrap some tape around these nails to prevent any scratching. We'll also need a 3-inch piece of pipe. This is a metal pipe screwed into a union, a metal union. So we'll only need half of it. We'll need this half. The reason for that is that this part will then go over the screw here. That will be to prevent slipping when we started to turn the screw in to compress the spring. Okay guys, so this is the action bedded down. And this is how it would look. Just for safety, we'll just tie down the action. And this is where this 3-inch piece of pipe with the union comes in. So that is how it looks. Okay, for the final piece of the puzzle, this is where the leash comes in. It goes around the muzzle of the gun and attaches to, passes over. So the leash will keep the muzzle from going forward, the action from going forward, while we screw out the vise, which compresses the spring. Okay guys, so here it is, fully assembled, starting at the muzzle. And the spring is fully compressed. So what we need to do now is just mark this off. Thank you.
And there it is. You can then take the spring out and the piston. So one of our next videos will be showing when we a new piston seal, and then we'll show you the reassembly.